Okay, so to give you an overview, we have a table of source data here, and it's a listing of transactions of people selling pet supplies. And then we created a pivot table, and it has two values. It has sum of the total price and a sum of the quantity. So this table is telling us the dollar value of selling these cat toys and how many we sold. If you come over to the right and you're just wanting to tell a little story in these boxes here, you just want to extract, hey, the leashes that we sold, let's break them out between brick and mortar and online. So what you think you would do, and will work if you don't change anything, is you would just hit an equal sign and then come over to the pivot table. And let's say we want leash sales for brick and mortar. Left click and sell D11. Hit enter. And there you go. So you have $2,537. That matches here. If you want it for online, you can take your mouse, go into the lower right-hand corner of the cell that you have selected until it becomes a plus sign. Hold your left mouse key and drag it down. You have both of these values coming up. If that's what you wanted and you're never going to change this pivot table, then you're fine. Just leave it like that. But if this pivot table is dynamic, I'm going to show you how it would break these formulas and then what you can do to get around that. So first I'll left click into the pivot table and that'll bring up the pivot table editor on the right hand side. And we'll scroll down to these two values so we have them in this order, total price and quantity. Let me just left click on one and I'm going to take the quantity and I'm going to put it above total price. So this is going to rearrange my pivot table and it put the quantities on the left and the total price on the right. If you look at my formula here that was pulling the price, now it's shifted to quantity. The formula didn't change. If I left click in it, it's still pointing at D11, but D11 has changed. It's not returning the same amount. So there is a way to get around this where if you build a formula looking at the pivot table, you can specify exactly what value you want it to return. I'm just going to do Control Z just to get things back to how they were. And we'll come down into cell H10. I'm going to type the equal sign. That's how you always start a formula. And then I'm going to start typing the name of my formula, which is going to be get pivot data. I'm going to come down, left click on that with my mouse, and Google Sheets, like it always does, is going to give us this little helper text to try to help explain what's going on. The first field that it's trying to look for is a value name. So the value names are the darker ones here at the top, sum of total price or sum of quantity. I'm wanting sum of total price, and since this is a string, you start it with quotes. And I would say sum of total price. Now that's not case sensitive, but I capitalize it the right way just so it looks nice. I think that's important, right? And then you do a comma because we're ready for the next value. And the next value is just any cell in this pivot table. Now the best practice is to choose one near the upper left-hand corner, because if you change this pivot table a lot and it shrinks and grows, and you choose a value down here in the lower right-hand corner, it may not be part of the pivot table if you shrink the pivot table. So we're just going to specify B4, and we're going to put dollar signs before the column and dollar sign before the row, and that just fixes the reference. And since our pivot table has a little bit more detail below, you're going to need to specify these two columns. So you're going to say the product is leashes and the location is brick and mortar. We need it to be leashes at the brick and mortar location. So leashes, if you look over to the left, are the product and the brick and mortar is the location. So first we're looking for products. So let's do our quotes again. Product, comma, is leashes. And leashes is the value that I typed in H9. So I could type in leashes, but I'm going to make this formula a little bit more dynamic, because if I come in here and I want to just type over leashes and type fish food, this formula will still work. So we're going to say, instead of typing leashes, we're going to click on H9. And I'm going to go into this formula and I'm going to fix the row so I can drag this formula down. You'll see that in a minute. So said the product's leashes, then I need to say that the location is brick and mortar, which is in G10. Again, I'm going to use cell reference there. But I'm not going to fix the row that specifies the product, because when I drag this down, I'm going to want G10 to increment the G11. So I'll type enter now, and then I'll go back to H10. I'm going to copy it. I'm going to paste it into H11, and then increment it down. So this is the GetPivotData function again, but instead of leashes and brick and mortar, it's looking at leashes and online. So if you come over to the pivot table, leashes online, 20,143. So if you watch me do that and you see these return the exact same amount, you would say, well, why would you put so much more effort into it just to get the exact same amount, right? Who cares? Well, there's so many times that you can build a formula that relies on a value, but then that value changes. So if I come into this pivot table, so let's just come in here again and change the order of the values and see what happens. So if you look at the formulas that were simple cell reference broke. They're not returning what you wanted. So that's returning 10. That's the count of the quantities. That's not a dollar value. The formatting stayed the same. So it still looks like it's dollars, but it's not. But the get pivot table function still works because it's looking for leashes in brick and mortar. And it also knows that you want the sum of the total price. So as with any formula, there's a few things to keep in mind. One of them is the sum of total price. If you left clicked on that and you just customize that header, let's just say we called it total dollars. It's going to break the pivot table function because there is nothing called the sum of total price anymore, as it's looking at the customized header. Just want to change it to say total dollars. And it works with the custom header. So we'll drag down that new formula. And there you go. So there's one more. I'm just going to delete these for now. I don't like looking at a broken formula. Another thing to keep in mind is that if you change the pivot table, you can rearrange things as long as these values that you're referencing in the get pivot data stay there. But if they're not shown in the pivot table, they won't return. So the get pivot data function is built to pull things out of a pivot table if they're visible. So if you take out the total price value, this function's not going to work anymore. So it's not calculating the total price. All it's doing is pulling it from the pivot table. And the value's not there, the function doesn't work. Let's undo that change, and there it is. So as you're building out formulas, you can put this function inside of other formulas to pull these results out. And it will work better than just a cell reference because it updates as the pivot table updates. So if you want to see this file and the accompanying notes and be able to work with it, and also see a collection of 11 other videos on how to build pivot tables, and they will all have linked files and notes, you can check out a course that I built down in the description. So next up is a video about a feature of a slicers that you can add to a pivot table that will let you filter the data on the fly, and the controls will stay right on top of your worksheet. See you in that next video. Thanks.